So let's talk today about the case analysis and how do you actually do it. So this video is predominantly going to be covering two things, which is the first thing that I want to focus is on the case discussion, and the second thing that I want to focus is on the case analysis, or you can say case writing also. I see a lot of people, right? It's interview season anyway, so like I see a lot of people. They kind of lack the flow and kind of the structure as far as the case analysis is concerned. So whenever any kind of a case which is given to you, maybe it can be an organizational case wherein company needs to get profitable, or maybe it's kind of an HR case wherein employee needs to be sacked or retained or something like that, or maybe it's kind of an ethical dilemma case, right? So I'm gonna give you a platform, I'm gonna give you a format, a structure, a skeleton which can be used across all the case studies. You during your MBA, pre-MBA, which is your MBA interviews, and even once you get into the MBA, you can use this format across. All right. So the first thing that you're going to start is the you will be writing problem statement. Now, what do you mean by problem statement? Problem statement is nothing but what is the main thing of your case study? Why you are writing this case study? What is the main issue? What is the main concern? What is the main problem or question that is arising from this case study? So you're going to be writing first thing as a problem statement. Now, this is as far as the case analysis is concerned, okay? So you can probably put it as case analysis or case writing also. Now, how are you going to use this for case discussion? Now, let's have a quick look at this. For example, if you're getting a case, right, which is based on a company which is not making a lot of profit, right, and you have to generate the profit. Now, if that case has been given to you, and if you're in a group discussion, or if you're doing a case discussion, you can always say that, you know what? Hello everyone. So the problem statement here in this case study is how to make this company profitable. So that's the main thing. That's the main thing that you guys are looking at. So that's going to be your problem statement. Your second statement, rather, your second platform or pro forma is going to be analysis. Now, this is going to be the crucial part of your case study entirely. Why? Because a lot of people, when they do the analysis, I don't see guys doing the analysis. Even the graduates, the MBA graduates, fail to do the analysis. What people do when they actually do case analysis, they assume a lot. So there are a lot of assumptions that comes into picture, which spoils the fun of the entire case study, which spoils the sanity of the entire case study. See, because understand this, why case study has been thrown at you? Because excuse me, why this case study has been thrown at you? Because you being a CEO or you being any CXO out there, right? If you've been given a database, say for example, there is a company which is not making profit, and you've been newly appointed as a CEO, and people say that, all your heads are telling you, sir, we have this much capital, we have this much resources, we have this much money left, and we have got, these many problems. Now, you as a CEO or you as a CFO, you have to deal with this case with respect to whatever resources which are available to you. You cannot say that, you know what, let's assume, what if market moves up? Let's assume, what if US economy gets stronger? We might have a good deal about it, right? Or let's say, what if we have good relationship with China? Blah, blah, blah. If you do all these things, a lot of assumptions will ultimately spoil your case study. So that's what the main point is. You've been given a case study. A case study is basically something wherein you have limitation, wherein you have constraint, and you have to use things at your discretion, whichever given to you. But a lot of people don't do that. They can completely kind of spoil the sanity of the entire case study, and then they start assuming the stuff. The more you assume, the case study is gonna go longer. And trust me, you as a group, you as an individual will never come to an analysis, or will never come to a conclusion. So first thing is that do not assume a lot of stuff. So you have to stick to data, whichever has been given to you. So stick it around, right? It's gonna help you. So assumptions you're not gonna do. What you're gonna do instead is, let me first of all talk about analysis. So when you start a case study, you can tell the group, this is the probable, this is the problem statement, and to analyze this case study, what we have is the database. So whatever database has been given to you, whatever information has been given to you, right, you can use that for solving a case study. Okay, now you have to analyze the same data. Now here comes something called as universal data. Now universal data is something which is definitely can be used anywhere. There are certain parameters, say for example GDP, right? You can talk about ease to do business ranking of India. You can talk about HDI ranking of India. You can talk about macroeconomics. You can talk about microeconomics, and any database which is connected to all these parameters, you can use them. Definitely, because you cannot assume these figures. You cannot assume these databases, right? Because this is the universal. This is basically static. It doesn't change all the time. It does, but not dramatically, right? So you can always say this, you can always take into consideration this kind of a database, which is most welcome. But you cannot assume if this happened, then what will happen? So if and but language is not going to work as far as your case study is concerned. So the second thing that you can do here is basically you can analyze this case on the basis of whatever information has been given to you. Now, once you analyze this, right, here what you can do is you can kind of bring in the hypothesis, okay? Now, hypothesis is a pretty cool thing. Why? Because hypothesis you can build up and you can say that, you know what, as a group or, you know, as an individual opinion, I would kind of generate the hypothesis. Hypothesis is something wherein you kind of assume couple of things which are damn important as far as your case study solution is concerned. But make sure that you don't have multiple assumptions or multiple hypotheses. Stick around 1, 2, 3 or maximum 3 to 4 hypotheses, you can say. You know what? So you can say, I would love to assume, or my hypothesis is on the basis of this. So this is going to be the this is going to be the background, or this is going to be the hypothesis or assumption on which my case study is going to get built up. So you can do that. So that's going to be number two. So do the analysis basis on the current database. Do not do the assumption. Number three, when you talk about your problem statement, when you talk about your analysis, your number three is going to be kind of a probable solution. Or here you will be talking about, all right, so what probable solutions I see. So fair enough, we can have maybe multiple solutions. So number one, number two, number three, you will have number couple of solutions. Then number four comes, rather talks about your risk management. Okay, now as a manager, okay, or as a management aspirant, it is always good to have probable solutions. But at the same point in time, you also need to understand, what if this doesn't work for you? Okay, then what's going to be your disaster management? What's going to be your risk management? So risk management is basically wherein you kind of introduce, if this fails, what is going to be the plan B, or what's going to be the backup? And then in the end, once you discuss everything, right, you can conclude your entire case study. So your statement, rather your case study, will have a flow, which is problem statement, analysis. Once you do the analysis, you can talk about the probable solution, then you have risk management, and then you can conclude that. That's going to be your entire flow as far as your case study is concerned. I can give you another thing as far as this thing are concerned. There's something called as Six Sigma. People who are aware about it, they can kind of connect to me, they can understand. Six Sigma provides you a very effective tool, which is nothing but DMEG. Okay, now what does DMEG mean? Is basically DMEG means define, define, so you define the problem, okay, major, you measure the intensity of the problem, how, what's gonna be the cost of this, then you analyze the data, okay, then you improve that. Improve is nothing but your solution. And once you improve that, you have to take care of it. It means you have to control it, making it sure that, you know, the problem never occurs in future. So that's how we're going to go ahead with, right? So you have Six Sigma. You can use, either you use this one or you use this one. Anything will work great for you. Now, when you do the analysis, or whenever you go ahead with the probable solution, I would kind of urge you guys to introduce some business models. Okay, you guys need to use some business models as far as these things are concerned. So I will be making a different video altogether on the business model also. But for the time being, I'm going to give you something which is, like, you know, in handy. So for example, if you're working on a case study which has a lot of problems and you need to come up with the solution, then you can probably draw this in your VAT also, in your case discussion also. You can probably include this in your case analysis also. So this is something called as Ishikawa model, or this is something called as Fishbone analysis, wherein you can actually talk about, this is a root cause analysis, right? So here you have all the cause, here you have a solution. Then you can talk about this kind of cause, solution. So you have problem, rather than talking about all the causes at one go and giving solutions at a one go, I think this is kind of a good, idea to kind of move ahead with your case study. The second thing that you can talk about is SWOT analysis. I know this is like kind of old, but yeah, you can still use that. Then you can talk about BCG analysis. This is gonna work fluently for all the, you know, kind of organization or company, kind of finance kind of based, or maybe marketing kind of case studies. So herein you have cash cow, herein you have got dog quadrant, here you have got a question mark quadrant, and here you have the star one, okay? You can also use 2x2 format, wherein, you can talk about high, low, kind of, you know, high, low kind of stuff. And that's how I want you to kind of present a database. Now, trust me, this is a presentation, okay? This is a presentation. You can also use POTUS 5 forces, wherein you can put in the problem between, say, women empowerment, and women empowerment is basically not happening. Why it's not happening? Because there are certain problems which hits it, right? So you can kind of, you know, talk about problem number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, something like that. You can use this in your VAT. You can use this in your case analysis or case writing. You can also use this in a case discussion. Here you can say that, you know what, to kind of, you know, put this across, I would love to use the BCG metrics, or I would love to use the 2x2 metrics, wherein we want to understand the high intensity of the problem and the low intensity, something like that. Or you can say that, you know what, let's understand this from a Ishikawa model. Let's go cause solution kind of a thing. And we should kind of direct our entire conversation in the discussion according to the Fishbone analysis. So we'll talk about a cause and then we'll talk about a solution. So we'll go like that. You can direct your group like this, right? You can use this kind of models. Then there is something called as competition model also. This is damn amazing. This is damn amazing. This is something I have taught in couple of base schools also. This is something I've taught in my classroom program also for the MBA aspirant. I'm gonna make a couple of more videos, talking about these business models. Trust me, they are gonna be with you throughout your life, because you will be working as a consultant or whatsoever, right? So yeah, so this is the, I think, the best way to kind of go ahead with your case study, your VAT writing, case writing, or your case discussion. So guys, if you have any doubt, any concern, any question, put the comment on the video. If you want me to kind of, you know, make a video for any kind of a case study out there, most welcome, put the comment on the video, and I wish you all the very best for your case study analysis, yeah? Thank you so much, guys. Have a good one.